Hi, so like I'm Jay. Stop. Let me start over.
Someone else go.
So I'm Jay. I'm pansexual and I'm trans.
That's cool.
I'm Quincy. I'm gay and I'm queer.
I'm Thomas and I'm straight and
I am Mylie and I'm transgender and I'm heterosexual.
My name is Mylie Clark. I was born Miles Lee. With transitioning, I feel like I just want to use like my originalness and kind of just make it my own. I grew up in Providence, Rhode Island. I moved around from Connecticut, West Warwick. I sing, I dance, I skateboard. I'm into art. Yeah.
Fashion. How do you feel when you were growing up?
It was bad. Like, my mom's a bishop, so I grew up in the church. It was very, very, very bad. I would, like, have thoughts about, like, private parts, and I'd just be like, damn, like, what the hell is wrong with me? Like, I'm crazy. Like, damn, this is crazy. I didn't really like women that much, but I knew that I thought they were pretty and that we could connect. And I used to hang around with like females a lot when I was younger, but people would make fun of me, like even my teachers and stuff. So I stopped and I was like, yeah, I'm not gonna do that. I was like, I don't want nobody talking about me or even having comments about me, like whatever. Like,
right.
I'll just start chilling with guys. And ever since then, like I've been chilling with guys, but like it was always hard to match myself with like a group of guys. That was my main issue, like having to hold all that stuff in my mind and my body and still try to present myself as a male and not look like I'm like all crazy or something.
Yeah. Did you always knew or did you always were questioning about your trans identity?
I would always like arch my back like all the way out, like very femininely, and those kind of like little behaviors started making me notice that I was weird, or not weird, but like just like different than other people, but like to people weird, like they wouldn't think of you like normal, as if they could almost feel it, or as if that like they knew that I was having those feelings.
Yeah. I definitely have like some of the same experiences, but like not with the arching in the back. There were moments in like my own life where I felt like where I would just like whip my hair, but like I didn't have hair, but obviously, but like I would just like whip my head around and just like feel good about it. But then the people around me would like judge. Well, they wouldn't necessarily say anything, but like I could feel their judgment in their eyes, and it always scared me. Like, what if my own family like treats me like this? Who's to say like anybody else wouldn't treat me differently? So like, how does it feel to be a Black trans woman in today's society?
Oh my gosh! Like, oh, it's bad. I went to LA Fitness or whatever, and as soon as I walk in, there's this like big dude at the front desk. He's giving me these little attitudes, like you're saying, like you could just tell, giving me these looks. I don't know what his problem is, but I know he don't like me. 10 minutes, and I walk in. This is from going to the store to get food because my blood sugar was low and I was working out. And he's like, oh, you can't keep running in and out of here like that. Like, where are you coming from? What are you doing? Like, just constant question after question after question. Like, why do I have to answer to you? Like,
right.
I just left to go get something and I'm coming back to the gym. Like, right. Who are you? If your name's not on the list, like, you can't be in here. You're not supposed to be in here. He's like, oh, no. Go find the person you're with. Go find him. So I go in the gym. I'm like, I can't find him. This is not going to look good. He walks back in the gym. He's like, so where's your brother? I'm like, oh, I don't know where he's at. He's not in here. Maybe he's somewhere else. Like, can I keep looking for him? Like, can I have a little more time? And he's just gone. Like, he won't stop. So we start arguing. And I'm a person that has a very bad temper. So I'm just telling him, shut up, over and over. I never touched him. Wasn't in his face, nothing.
Yeah.
But I guess just because the situation didn't go how he wanted it and he didn't have control or whatever, he, like, punched me in my face or whatever. And it became, like, if they didn't break it up and remove me, we probably would have fought and everything and like everything like that. But like still, he had no right to put his hands on me because he was a working person there.
Right.
Plus he was the one like coming for me.
You.
He wasn't harassing me.
Yeah.
I wasn't doing anything to him. I'm just like, is it a hate crime? Like, is he hitting me because I'm like feminine? Is that the reason why he attacked me in the first place? People just feel like they can do whatever they want because you're different than them. Like, if you're not a complete cis female, or even sometimes if you are a cis female, they feel like this person's weaker than me. I have the advantage. Like, let me take the advantage over them. As a black trans woman in society, I just try to, like, keep my mouth shut and just, like, do me and not get sucked up into everything, because it's very bad now. Like, people just don't like different people.
We know that you were incarcerated in a men's prison. We just wanted to know more, like, about how did that happen? Like, what was going on through your mind?
I don't know what does it, but, like, almost every guy in there was just, like, constantly having a comment about everything I did. Or, like, just like you said, the looks. I went to AMOD first, and, well, AMOD last. But usually, every other time I get arrested, that's the first mod they put me in. And that's, like, where they torture me. Like, they just want to, like, make fun of me. I think someone's, like, oh, you're a fag or whatever. I just keep walking, trying to brush it off. Someone else says something. I don't even remember what they said, but that's when I snapped. I'm just like, I'm not staying here. Like, there's no way I'm gonna stay here. I'm gonna fight someone, or I'm gonna get in trouble. I'm gonna get more time. Like, I'm not staying here. Like, I don't wanna be here. I don't feel safe. I wanna go to another mod. Like I anything but this. Like, I don't wanna be here. And he's like, oh, it's not a hotel. Like, who do you think you are? Like, you don't come here and have privilege. Like, this isn't a hotel. I'm not trying to act like anything. I don't feel like I'm special or nothing, but, like, they're making fun of me. I just don't want to be here. I don't feel safe. Now he's getting in my face even more. Like, he's just all in my face, yelling at me and everything, spitting all in my face or whatever. So now we're arguing, and he's telling me to hit him. He's like, hit me, like, hit me, like, hit me. And I'm like, a CO? I'm like, you're a CO. Like, how did it get from me trying to get out of here to you telling me to hit you? So they stick me in a seg, and I go to seg maybe like a week, 2 weeks, because you're starting problems with the inmates and now the COs. I just kept trying to remove myself, and they would never listen to me. If no one's gonna help me, I don't know what to do. Guess my only way to deal with it was sucking it up, closing my mouth, maybe like writing, doing art, eating. Honestly, talking to myself. I didn't talk to anyone in jail.
You grew up in the church and your mother was a bishop, right? Yeah. I mean, I'm in Niagara right now. I go to church, and, like, you're taught certain things. How is coming out to your mom, like?
My mom said I knew, because my mom's brother was homosexual, so that was her favorite brother. They sung together. And my mom was always, like, my best friend, so it worked out. With the makeup and the nails and the hair, my mom was weirded out about that. Very weirded about. She's like, don't do that inside. Like, don't do that around anybody. Just because of people, like, they think you're different. It's like the whole other thing.
Growing up, did you have any, like, queer, like mentors that you could have looked up to?
My only queer mentor I looked to literally was Frank Ocean. Because I always thought I was gay, so I'm never going to be a gay singer. When Frank Ocean came out, I was like, damn, this is cool.
Are you in love?
Honestly, I have never, ever, ever been in love yet. Like, never. Never.
Would you consider yourself to be the heartbreaker or the heartbroken?
Oh, man. I can say it over and over as much as time as I want to. I would love to be the heartbreaker, but I'm too soft. Like, I don't know. When I love somebody or care about somebody, they're going to know. Like, I'm going to always show it.
Rihanna or Beyonce?
Oh my God! I haven't heard that in so long. Rihanna. Yeah! That was my wife. That was my wife. Oh, I was in love with Rihanna. Oh my God. That's when we believe it. That's when we believe it. Believe you won't deceive me.